Hello, goaltending students. My name is Gavin Sclair. Welcome to Goalie Smarts. Why fuck with a
dope dealer? Being selected for a team is a roll of the dice. Ideally, we'd all love to play for an amazing team with impeccable defense and not have to play goalie whatsoever. If it was our choice, we'd just sit in our crease, do nothing all game, and be nothing more than a cheerleader in an expensive uniform. Some of us, however, are not so lucky, and we get stuck with the mouth-breathing fuckwads who shoot pucks at our own goal, set up beautiful one-timers for our opponents, and hand police officers debit cards when they ask for their license. Doesn't matter how good of a goaltender you are, there is very little hope for you. So in Goalie Smarts episode 14, I'm going to teach you how to cope with playing for a terrible team. Step one, patch up what you can. Let's face it, you have lost the lottery. In essence, this is like having a child that wears Crocs with a straight face. Since you have no choice but to ride it out, it is your responsibility to fix up whatever you can. I would suggest inviting teammates to things like skill sessions, off-ice training, stick and puck, and maybe even therapy.
Did you really trick me into seeing a shrink?
Dude, don't be so close-minded, alright? The team's doing pretty bad. I really think this could benefit everybody.
This is probably the weirdest shit I've ever fucking done.
Hey guys.
What's up?
Now, are you Jimmy?
Yeah, how do you know my name?
Nick's been talking about you for a really long time. He said that one time you actually passed the puck in front of the net while a winger was waiting, and he one-timed it in.
I mean, yeah, I was just trying to get the puck out of the zone.
Ah, yes, I see. What Nick and I were actually wondering is what was going through your head at the time? Because, quite frankly, that was probably the dumbest thing you could have done.
Did you just invite me here to shit on me?
Yeah.
Step 2. Adapt to your environment. Since own goals, shitty plays, and countless hours in your own zone are now your reality, you have no choice but to step your game up. I know playing for a shitty team might suck right now, but imagine how good you'll be after an entire season of unqualified defensemen desperately trying and failing to keep the puck away from you. You'll not only learn how to stop intentional shots from opponents, but you'll also learn how to stop unintentional shots from dumbass teammates. You'll be seeing more rubber than a Colombian prostitute. If you were looking for more practice as a goalie, congratulations, you fucking got it. This is like wanting a box of Lucky Charms and waking up to truckloads of Lucky Charms in your kitchen. Hope you like Lucky Charms, bitch. Your wish has been granted. Step 3, fuck it. At some point in the season, you will reach this point. There is nothing you can do about your shitty team, so you might as well have fun with it. Try to make every practice and game your own personal party. And since no party is complete without drugs, make sure you bring plenty, both with you and in your system. Do not leave for a game or practice without being belligerently fucked up, and do not leave without drugs to give to your friends. Not only is this a much more fun way to pass the time, it's also a great business opportunity. Think about it. Every entrepreneur searches for a product that everybody wants, and when everyone on your team sees you having so much fun, they're gonna wanna join in. This is called marketing. This is also a great backup plan if your hockey career ever goes in the shitter. Think about it. You'll have a product, a loyal clientele, and a growth strategy. You'll be the Rick Ross of Saskatoon, Saskatchewan. Thanks for listening, guys. If you would like to see the latest sketch on LaBeouf Comedy, it's hilarious as always. Click right here. If you would like to buy some Guillaume Duclair apparel and look sexy as fuck, click right here. I'm Guillaume Duclair. I'm out.